Neil Davis, fitness trainer and health educator with Neil Davis Fitness. And on this Wellness Wednesday, I want to talk to you about some tips for losing weight after the age of 40. Last week, I was fortunate enough to be able to make it to 51 years of life on this earth. And there are people who ask me, how do you do it? How is it that you're able to keep in shape after all of these years? And I just want to share some of what I've learned. It's going to be the first in a series that I'll be doing for the next few weeks about some tips that we can use if you're trying to lose weight after the age of 40. The first thing that I want to talk about is hydration. You want to make sure that you're choosing healthy hydration. Drinks like sweetened coffee beverages, soda, juices, sports drinks, and pre-made smoothies are mostly chock full with calories and added sugars. If you're drinking sugar sweetened beverages, especially those sweetened with high fructose corn syrup, that is strongly linked to weight gain, conditions like obesity, heart disease, diabetes, and fatty liver disease. Swapping sugary beverages out with healthy drinks like water instead and herbal tea can help you lose weight and may considerably reduce your risk of developing the chronic conditions mentioned above. The next thing I'd recommend is to limit your added sugars. It's important that we make sure that we're limiting that. So limiting foods that are high in added sugar, including sweetened beverages, which I just talked about, candy, cakes, cookies, ice cream, sweetened yogurts, and sugary cereals is critical for weight loss at any age because sugar is added to so many foods, including items that you wouldn't expect, like tomato sauce, salad dressing, and bread. Reading ingredient labels is the best way to determine if an item contains added sugar. Look for added sugars on the nutrition facts label or search the ingredient list for common sweeteners such as cane sugar, high fructose corn syrup, and agave. Next thing is to improve your sleep quality. Not getting enough quality sleep can harm your weight loss efforts. Many studies have shown not getting enough sleep, what it does is increases your likelihood of obesity and it may hinder your weight loss efforts. For example, there's a two-year study in 245 women, and it demonstrated that those who slept 7 hours per night or more were 33% more likely to lose weight than women who slept less than 7 hours per night. So better sleep quality is also associated with weight loss success. So aim to get the recommended 7 to 9 hours of sleep per night and work on improving your sleep quality by minimizing light in your bedroom and avoiding using your phone or watching TV before bed. The next thing, the fourth thing, would be focusing on your body composition. Muscle mass is an important measure of overall health, especially in older adults. So packing on more muscle and losing excess fat should be your goal. So although body weight is a good indicator of your health, your body composition, we're talking about the percentages of fat and fat-free mass in your body, that's important as well. Now, there are many ways to measure your body fat percentage. However, simply just measuring your waist, which is right by your belly button, your biceps, your calves, your chest, and thighs can help you determine if you're losing fat and gaining muscle. The fifth thing and the last thing I'll talk about today is just being more mindful, being more aware. If you're aware of what you're eating, this is a simple way to improve your relationship with food. All the while, it encourages weight loss. So mindful eating involves paying more attention to your food and your eating patterns. Gives you a better understanding of your hunger and fullness cues, as well as how food impacts your mood and your well-being. There are no scientific or specific rules to mindful eating, but if you eat slowly, pay attention to the aroma and flavor of each bite in food, and keep track of how you feel during your meals, those are simple ways to introduce mindful eating to your life. So again, this has been Neil Davis with Neil Davis Fitness, encouraging you to make sure you follow these tips. So if you're over the age of 40, it works even if you're in your 20s or your 30s. All of these are important ways to make sure, again, you're being the best version of yourself. So until next week, again, this has been Neil Davis with Neil Davis Fitness, reminding you once more to be the best version of yourself. And until next week, have a great day.